Alright guys, welcome back to your boy Prince TV. If it's your first time of coming across to this platform, please try to subscribe to this amazing platform so that anytime we upload a video, you'll always be the first person to be notified so that you know what our video is all about. Once again, let me remind you guys what this channel is meant for. It's all about to give you updates on document issue and then also entertain you in a way that it might be funny but still the same thing to bring a nice update. When our African leaders misbehave, or most of the leaders here in European side, any of the leader that misbehave, we also make our action video to make them know. You understand, bringing the reality to everyone in such a funny way. All right, moving straight to the reason why I am here about the article of this senatorial. The reason why senatorial is not meant for everybody. Guys, you will be shocked and then get this update this way. But that is the real truth because I'm going to give you guys proof and evidence. So stay tuned to this particular video and know the reason why senatorial document was not meant for all sectors of workers here in Italy. Alright, as we all know that Teresa Bellanova brought out this senatorial disturbing the government because she was lacking laborers or workers in her own field as the Minister of Agriculture during the pandemic when the situation was high. This lady was a kind of like looking for workers, and then people who come to work here in Italy, most of them are seasonal workers who come from Bangladesh or that country. So when this lady find out and say, okay, the people who ought to come here and work because of the pandemic, they can never come anymore because of the coronavirus issue. And then this lady twisted everything to say, okay, fine, since we have immigrants here in Italy, I think making these immigrants to be regular in order for me to make use of them to do my work, I think that would be the best way. So that was how Teresa Bellanova was a kind of like a pushing for, saying that they have to regularize immigrants who are working under agriculture. That was the major place that she was feeling. Well, guys, though this lady, I'm not standing against her, neither anyone standing against her. She herself really wanted the senatorial as well to go for all sectors of workers. But the way she kind of like demanded the senatorial, it was somehow upset to the government, which they now focus on her demand only, forgetting the one of Luciana Lemojese, who first of all introduced that they have to make senatorial for all workers here in Italy, irrespective of where you are working. Alright, now the first video I'm going to display here is to make you guys understand the first senator, one of the first senator in the parliament, who was a kind of like a saying that when is Lemojese going to make the senatorial for all workers here in Italy. So guys, listen to this video. If I'm back, I will explain more to you guys.
La ringrazio, Presidente. Ministra, per effetto del cosiddetto decreto sicurezza noi abbiamo assistito a un aumento dei dinieghi alle domande di protezione internazionale, a un conseguente aumento nel nostro paese dei cittadini irregolari. In attesa che ci sia una riforma della normativa sull'immigrazione, un provvedimento straordinario di emersione di questi cittadini che consenta la regolarizzazione a fronte di una immediata disponibilità all'assunzione e che quindi consenta loro di avere, nel momento in cui c'è matura questa disponibilità e c'è l'assunzione, un permesso di soggiorno, consentirebbe al nostro Paese di effettuare una grande operazione di legalità e anche di effettiva e reale sicurezza. Quindi chiediamo se il Governo intenda assumere un provvedimento di questo tipo e quando.
All right, guys, so you saw when that man was asking a question to Luciana Lemojese. So that was the first discussion of senatorial in the Italian parliament, which they want to make, you understand? So that man asked the question, okay, fine, when are they going to make senatorial for all workers here in Italy? So then Luciana Lemojese tried to respond to that particular senator who asked that question. So guys, now let's watch the video when Luciana Lemojese respond to the question of the senatorial that she intends to make.
Onorevoli deputati, l'onorevole interrogante richiama l'ordine del giorno accolto il 23 dicembre scorso in sede di approvazione della legge di bilancio, con il quale il Governo si è impegnato a valutare l'opportunità di varare un provvedimento che, a fronte dell'immediata disponibilità di un contratto di lavoro, consenta la regolarizzazione di cittadini stranieri irregolari già presenti in Italia, prevedendo all'atto della stipula del contratto il pagamento di un contributo forfettario da parte del datore di lavoro e il rilascio di un permesso di soggiorno per il lavoratore.
Guys, so you listened to that particular video when that lady was trying to explain everything. So that was the re sanatoria which the Italian government supposed to make before this Teresa Bellanova came to be disturbing them in that way that led Luciana Lemongezi to even forget what she was intending to make. So now, if you listen to that particular Italian that lady just spoke now, was trying to explain that all migrants or foreigners who are present here in Italy with contract of work, that they have to leave a permesso di soggiorno per i lavoratori. That is to say, to leave a permesso di soggiorno for workers here in Italy. So that is to let you know that Luciana Lemongezi, which is the Minister del Interno, the sanatoria she was proposing to make was to be for all set of workers, irrespective of where you are working, you are doing moratorium, any type of work you are doing, magazineering, you have the right to apply for this sanatoria. So I think with this video, I'm able to convince you, let you know that, you know, this Teresa Bellanova, though she's not a bad lady, she as well tried to kind of like push the government so that they can regularize a set of people here in Italy. So what I'm trying to make you guys understand here is that, hadn't been that this Luciana Lemongezi was still standing to her point of view, according to what she said, that, you know, the present the present immigrants here in Italy, that they all have to be granted un permesso di soggiorno per i lavoratori qui in Italia. So as a matter of fact, the Teresa Bellanova kind of like twisted everything in a fast way, and then it kind of like push a frustration to the government, and then they selected, okay, fine, since you are disturbing us to the extent that this lady was even crying.
L'ultimo punto, Presidente, che voglio richiamare e che per molti può essere considerato un punto non un punto accessorio, per me, per la mia storia, è un punto fondamentale. E mi riferisco all'articolo 110 bis.
So this lady was crying because of immigrants saying that they have to kind of like give the workers here in Italy, those who are working in her own particular sector, most especially that is the agricultural workers, to give them documents in order for them to continue the activity, since the people who come for seasonal workers cannot do it anymore. So guys, I think you get this fact now, that, you know, hadn't been that this Luciana Lemongezi was still standing on it, the sanatoria would have gone for everyone and everybody would have been a benefit to this particular sanatoria, you understand? All right, okay, now let's watch another video again now. The first senator who already brought that update to ask Luciana Lemongezi, when are they going to start the sanatoria that she was kind of like proposing? Let's hear what that particular man is still saying about immigrants, and then if I come back, I will explain to you guys.
Presidente, io ringrazio la ministra dell'Interno, perché credo che in questa espressione di una volontà di approfondire, anche di una volontà politica, insomma, nell'ambito di una più generale, come c'è stato, come abbiamo ascoltato, revisione delle norme, delle nostre norme del testo unico sull'immigrazione, voglio vedere appunto l'intenzione di andare verso un provvedimento di questo tipo. Auspico che ci sia, che questo governo trovi in tempi rapidi questa volontà politica, perché credo che noi avremmo benefici su vari livelli. Intanto noi abbiamo un sistema produttivo italiano che ci chiede un provvedimento di questo tipo. Noi abbiamo in questo momento, per effetto del decreto sicurezza, cittadini che stanno perdendo il lavoro perché hanno perso la loro condizione di regolarità ed erano ad esempio beneficiari di una protezione umanitaria. Non solo, dobbiamo anche dire che non è sufficiente, non sarebbe sufficiente allargare i casi speciali di concessione della protezione umanitaria, perché avremmo comunque quei cittadini che ricevono un diniego alla loro richiesta di protezione e che stanno ingrossando le file degli irregolari. In questo momento sono circa 600.000 nel nostro paese, le stime più accreditate ci dicono che potrebbero arrivare a 700.000 alla fine del 2020. Nessuna democrazia, nessuno Stato democratico può consentirsi di avere nel proprio paese 700.000 cittadini che sono dei fantasmi e degli irregolari e che magari hanno un datore di lavoro pronto ad assumerli domani.
All right, guys, so you saw that wonderful senator what he's trying to explain there. For those of you who don't understand Italy, what that man is trying to say there is that, you know, that they should regularize all immigrants present here in Italy who have work doing, who have contract of work, that they should give them permesso di soggiorno. And then that particular man was still even a kind of like explaining that, you know, there are some people who might have work tomorrow, but they don't have the permesso di soggiorno, all this will be a problem. You hear when you speak that Italian that, you know, there will be some people who will have the work to do, but for the fact that they don't have this permesso di soggiorno, and then they cannot do this work. So that man was even trying to go to the extent of giving documents to even those ones who are not having this particular contract. So guys, this is the update I have for you. This video is something historical, trying to, like, you know, reflect back how the sanatorium went and then the rightful sanatorium that was supposed to made. I think thousands of people would have been having possible to get this sanatorium, because there are some people who are working in magazzinieri who even have life contracts, have tempo indeterminato, have different type of contracts in different set of sectors of work. I think those people supposed not to even look for a bus to apply this sanatorium. Already they have been working, so it would have been that the Italian are the one holding them. You understand? So guys, this is the update. What I'm trying to make here is for you guys to pray that Luciano Lamorgese should think about the other sectors which they left behind, so that they can try to give documents to others as well, because tax is tax, everybody is paying tax. So irrespective of where you are working, they are all money, all are going for the government economic. So that is the update I have for you. If you have not subscribed to this platform, please try to subscribe, hit the like button, share out our video. Till next time again, we meet together, we'll bring you updates. Ciao.